Please go over. Roll call.
Mark McLaren.
Here.
Larry Watson.
Here.
Billy Cloud.
Here.
Item number three, pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Item number four, recognize guests and thank all of our guests for being here today. Item number five, new business. Bill Dunn, good new business. Larry?
No.
Terry?
I do, I guess. In the budget this year, I'm asking for more money for more employees. I think what I bring in from the jail will balance out pretty close, but one of the reasons I'm asking for more employees, it's not a compliance issue, even though that would be nice, but I just brought, this is from 1 week. We did a shakedown, cleaned out the cells, found cell phones, shanks, you know, whatever, contraband, and then 7 days later, same jail pod. That's what we find. So it's a safety issue, why I'm asking, you know, for more employees if anybody wonders. Plus, I'd like to hire 2 more deputies for the sheriff's side because we have 1 deputy out by himself, you know, on almost every shift. When we have extras out, it's because the guys come in on their time to help. Another deal, having more plumbing issues. The 3 nights in a row last week, cells flooded. We had plumbers up there at midnight. Thinking about buying our own commercial snake. I don't know if you guys think that'd be worthwhile or even where I could buy one. I mean, Rick might know. We've got almost a brother-in-law that's a plumber. He might know where to find one at. If it's worthwhile, if it's too expensive.
Have they used them out there? Is that what they're using to get you on stuff?
Yeah, something that will reach at least 175 feet.
Well, they don't know where to get one. The plumber didn't know where to get one.
Yeah. Well, I thought they might know, but other than that, that's all the new business I have.
I've got a question if you don't mind.
Okay.
How are they getting it sent?
I don't know where these are coming from. I don't even know what that is. It's aluminum, some sort of too sharp. But these here are coming off like mop buckets. They'll get back there and they'll bust the mop buckets and then throw all the pieces back out and those come off them. So I've told the jailers, I said, stand there and watch them use it and pull them back out as soon as they get through. But stuff is still getting back there. I don't know. They get cell phones back there. They get contraband. I had 4 more cameras installed so I can see the doors. And they're recorded to see exactly what's coming in and out, you know, if we can even tell.
That looks like it's been sharpened.
How
would they have sharpened them? Just on the concrete?
Just on the concrete. Like that one there, it's unbelievable, the points on it.
You got 24/7.
Got plenty of time sharpened.
I mean, 24/7 to think of stuff like this.
And sometimes, you know, if there's a fight or somebody's got some kind of issue, a jailer will run in there to help them. I'm telling them, don't do it. You know, I don't care what's going on, don't do it until help gets there.
Not knowing what you're going to run into.
You know, they forced the door open on April here a while back and had her on the ground. And if it hadn't been for trustees running there and fighting them, you know, it could have been a bad day. But the trustees that were out running there and jumped on them, it was a fist fight. When I come around the corner, that's all I can see is like 20 people in fist fight. I hollered somebody go grab a shotgun. We kind of broke them up then. Yeah. I'm just concerned this day and age how people are mean. But I thought you guys seeing this might, you know, kind of
so what we go through with.
Yeah,
see what we have to deal with.
Brings a little reality to it.
But other than that, that's all I've got.
No other new business. We'll move on to item number 6, approve commissioner's proceedings from previous meeting.
are. There was discussion after that ATR when we had no action. We approved contingent on the adjustments.
Because the ones in your boxes.
Well, we can prove it, just need to change it.
Okay, I'll make sure.
Contingent on the change. I'll make a motion to approve contingent on changes.
I'll say.
Bart McLeary.
Yeah.
Larry Watson.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes. Item number 7, approved blanket PO, do you have any blankets? Looks like we have one to I&B Napa, $200, District 3. O'Reilly's, $200, District 3. Stigler Stone, $5,000, District 3. Brady's Tire, $200, District 3. That's this week's blanket PO.
Make a motion to approve.
I'll second it.
Bart McLeary.
Yes.
Larry Watson.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes. Item number 8, review and sign of approved ODOT lease purchase agreement number 311027 for Haskell County. This is on the new dump truck. Get financing through the revolving fund. Payments, 72 payments at $1,878.90 per month. I'll make a motion to approve this.
Second.
Bart McLeary.
Yes.
Larry Watson.
Yes.
Billy Cloud.
Yes. Okay, moving on to item number 9, review and sign of approved cooperative agreement with Oklahoma Department of Agriculture and Forestry Wildlife Service to bid. And this is for the yearly contract with for the beaver extermination and
hogs,
wild hogs also.
Yeah.
What is your name?
Dylan Bowers.
Dylan?
Yeah, I'm a new county trapper. I took Ty Gibbs' place. So, been trying to get on the beaver work that you guys have kind of told me about. So, just came to bring the yearly contract by.
What else can I smell for you guys? I make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Clark McLaren?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Dylan Bauer?
Yes.
Did you ever blow any down?
I haven't. I know I have in the past. I just have to date them out.
Having much luck there northeast of town on that 90-acre slough with all the cat poop?
Oh, I think I've taken 7 or 8 out of there. I think I'm about wrapping up.
Oh, you're a long way.
Well, I mean, just that. Section there.
You got an extra card?
I have some in the truck. I can write down my number for you if you want me to write it on the paper there.
Okay, we'll move on. Item number 10, discuss, consider final plan on Middle Board House Annex building. We have that deal. I think everybody's had an opportunity this morning to look at it. I'm gonna make a motion to approve it.
Second.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Dylan Bauer?
Yes.
Clark McLaren?
Yes.
Pasco County and Pittsburgh region with the extension center contract.
Make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Clark McLaren?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Dylan Bauer?
Yes.
State off. Moving on to item number 12, review and sign approved engagement letter for Oklahoma State Auditor for the Pasco County Treasurer's Office Turnover Order, Director's Office.
Make a motion to approve.
I'll second.
Clark McLaren?
Yes.
Larry Watson?
Yes.
Dylan Bauer?
Yes.
Item number 13, discuss, consider reappointment of Cox Insurance as Pasco County Insurance Agent.
That's you, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Got anything to say on it?
You had a rate increase. Well, you had an increase in premium, and most of it is due to the appraising that they did recently this year. All your values went up on your buildings. There is a $15,000 increase on your deductible fund, which is your money. You prepay it, and then if you pay it. Last year, it was $15,000 less, and this year, they've raised it. That's the underwriting system that ECHO handles that, and I don't know how they determine that, but I think they look at past years of losses. They try to keep it at a certain ratio.
Is y'all's fee a percentage, or how does that?
Yes, it is a percentage, yeah. And it's only based on the property and the liability. We don't put any percentage on your deductible money that you put in there. Yeah, and we're half of what normal insurance commissions are.
Make motion to approve.
I'll second it.
Mark McLaren?
Yes.
Randy Watson?
Yes.
Bill Cloud?
Item number 15, review and sign of approved resolution, property and liability quote. Exceeding. We have that.
How much was it?
I'm sorry, here you go.
$228,000.
Yeah, total is $225,161 if you paid it in a lump sum, or it's $90,360 for first payment is $112,581, second payment $115,433.
Cost of $2,000 for the period. That's why we generally pay it.
We've always
split it.
I mean, we took back to the treasurer's office a few times, and they always said we needed to split it. And we didn't have that much land around.
I'll make a motion to approve it. Make a resolution.
Okay, option two, right?
Yes.
I'll second.
Mark McLaren?
Yeah.
Randy Watson?
Yes.
Bill Cloud?
Yes.
Well, one of them is the workers' comp. 14's workers' comp. I skipped it.
I think you did workers' comp last year. We usually don't deal with the workers' comp part of it. I think that's the one that we would care to.
So we do just no accident anymore?
Yeah.
Laura. Item number 16, review and sign of approved appropriations, transfer appropriations, check receipt, bill, food covered.
I'll make motion to approve.
I'll second.
Mark McLaren?
Yes.
Larry Walton?
Yes.
Billy Cloud?
Yes.
Thank you, by the way.
You're welcome.
Appreciate you.
If y'all have any questions, or anything, let me know, and go over your list for us.
Will do.
We didn't turn this in yet.
But the one on the page just shows insurance is falling.
Oh, why he has that down? This one from the
body shop.
Body shop. I thought we were paying for it.
Made it so. signs, we'd like to have them back.
Okay.
We just got a bill for them.
Sounds like the park bill all back.
Yeah.
I
Go ahead and get it.
Okay, we got the executive session going today. No action on 17, item number 18 is adjourned.
Make motion adjourned.